Hi guys, this is Raj. I am going to take you through what is a ticketing tool. So guys, by the end of this video, you will be learning what is a ticketing tool, why the companies use ticketing tool, and what are the most used ticketing tools and the interface of a ticketing tool. So guys, what is a ticketing tool actually? So the ticketing tool is an integral part of every CRM guys. CRM means customer relationship management. So whenever you got an interaction, so if you're working as a service desk analyst, or if you're working as a technical support analyst, or if you may be working as a desktop support engineer. So once you got the interaction, so and once the customer says I'm facing so and so issue, then you will be asking the basic questions like what is the issue, what is the error message, and from how long are you facing the issue. Then you perform the troubleshooting steps and you resolve the issue. But the thing is that where you're going to mention all these things and how come your manager or your team lead knows that, so you have performed so and so steps to resolve this particular issue. So here the ticketing tool comes into picture guys. So in the ticketing tool, you can enter the details of the customer, the company ID of the customer, and for what issue he is calling, and what are the troubleshooting steps performed by you. So you can mention each and everything in the ticketing tool so that the management can know why the customer interacted with you, and what issue the customer has initiated an interaction, and what are the resolution you have given. So guys, why the companies use ticketing tool? So a ticketing system is a customer service tool that helps companies manage their service and support access. So from the ticketing tool, the companies can manage their service guys. So from the ticketing tool, they can know how many incidents we got today. And how many incidents have been resolved, and how many incidents have been pending. So the company can know, how many issues they have been supported in a day, or in a month, or in an year. And even the company can know what are the most issues they are getting, what are the most common issues the employees are getting. And it becomes easy for the management to identify which agent is taking more interactions. So if you are taking around like 30 to 40 interactions in a day, so 30 to 40 incidents will be created on your name in the ticketing tool. And by looking at the ticketing tool, you can know that you have took the 40 incidents in a day. And even the management can find out which agent is performing good, which agent is taking more interactions, and which agent is giving resolution to the incidents. And they can also know what all the tickets are under pending under any of the agent, and what all the tickets are under in progress. And guys, what are the most used ticketing tool? The most commonly used ticketing tools are ServiceNow, Remedy, Zendesk, and LiveAgent. Apart from this, there are n number of ticketing tools available in the market guys. So I am going to show the interface of ServiceNow ticketing tool. So guys, the ServiceNow ticketing tool interface will be like this guys. Here on the left side, you can see options called as create new, assign to me, open unassign, resolved, all, overview, critical incidents map. So guys, before getting into the ServiceNow ticketing tool, first let me make you to understand what is an incident number actually. So guys, here you can see the number, right? Under number you can see INC001002, INC001001. So these are all called as incident number guys, and they are also called as the ticket numbers, or if not the case IDs. So if you want to create a new ticket, and once you click on create new, you can create a new ticket guys. If you want to know what all the tickets have been assigned under your name, you can click on assign to me guys on the left side, assign to me. So once you click on assign to me, you can see all the tickets which are under your name. And if you want to open any incident number, so if the customer makes a call to you and he says that I have this incident number, I'm facing so and so issue, and for the last time the issue has been resolved, but still I'm facing the same issue, and he helps you with the incident number, the previous incident number, then you can go to open And once you click on open, you can type the incident number over there and you can get the information of the complete incident, guys. So why the customer called previously and what is the issue. You can know what is the previous issue and what is the current issue. And you can also know what all the troubleshooting steps performed by the previous analyst on that incident. And guys, so if you click on create new, then you can create a new ticket, guys. So see here, number, the incident number will be generated automatically, guys. Once you click on create new, then the incident number will be generated automatically. No need of doing anything to the incident number, guys. You need to fill up the data like a caller name. You need to confirm the caller name and you need to fill up the data, the category, subcategory, service, configuration item, contact type, state, impact, urgency, priority, assignment group and assigned to. So guys, when it comes to the category, you have these options, guys. None, enquiry or help, software, hardware, network or database. And based upon the customer's issue, you need to differentiate whether it's a software issue or a hardware issue or a network issue or a database issue. For example, if the customer makes a call to you and he says that, hey, do you know what, I'm unable to open so and so application. So then it comes under the software issue. As the issue is with the application, it comes under the software issue. And in the services, and under the services, you can mention the name of that application, guys. Under the services, you can mention the name of that application. And even under the subcategory, once you mention the name of that application, it could be automatically filled by the services, guys. And if the issue is an hardware issue, if the customer says that I'm facing issue with my keyboard, it's not working properly, then it comes under the hardware issue. And under category, you need to select the hardware. And under subcategory, you need to select the part of the hardware, guys, whether it's the problem is with the keyboard or whether the problem is with the hard drive or whether the problem is with the mouse. You need to select that. And when it comes to the state, guys, when it comes to the state, you have all these options, guys. New, in progress, on hold, resolved, closed and cancel. So the new comes into picture. Once you click on the create new, then the state will be as new, guys. Then the status of the ticket will be as new. And if the issue has been resolved, if the customer's issue has been resolved by you, then you will be placing the ticket under resolved, guys. And if something is to be done from your end, if something is to be done from the support center end, then the ticket will be in progress, guys. And we will never be closing the ticket, because once we put the ticket status in resolved, after 30 days or after 60 days, depending upon the organization, after 30 days or after 60 days, the ticket will be automatically changed to closed, guys. The ticket status will be automatically changed to closed. And you will be canceling the ticket whenever you create some duplicate tickets. Whenever you create some duplicate ticket, you will be canceling. And depending upon the organization, guys, depending upon the organization policies, you will be canceling few tickets. So for those tickets, the status would be as canceled. And guys, look at here, impact, urgency and priority. So depending upon the type of issue, you will be selecting the urgency as high, low or moderate. Even this urgency and impact priority depends upon the organization policies, guys. It differs from organization to organization. For example, this is a very common example, guys. So if the user make a calls to you and he says that, hey, do you know what, my laptop is not booting up. So as the customer says that he is facing a problem with the laptop boot up, so he is unable to do any kind of work, guys. So it's showing impact to the business. So as it's showing impact to the business, we can mark the ticket urgency under high. And in another scenario, if the customer make a calls to you and he says that I'm unable to open this URL. So the customer says that I'm unable to open this URL in Internet Explorer. Then you may go ahead and you ask the user to try with Microsoft Edge Chromium, or if not with the Google Chrome. And then the customer says that, hey, now it's working now. So you can mark the ticket as under low because you have given the resolution, right? You have given the resolution, the URL is working now. So you can mark the ticket urgency as low. In all the resolved cases, the impact, urgency and priority will be low, guys. And next, assignment group. When it comes to the assignment group, there will be different type of groups, right? There will be different type of groups within the organization. So if you're working under the help desk group, then the assignment group should be like help desk. And if you're working in some other escalations group, then the assignment group should be like escalations. And if you are escalating the ticket to the any tier 3 or any networking team or any other team, then the assignment group should be the team name, guys. And if you're assigning the ticket to you, if you want to assign the ticket to you, then you need to click on this search button and then you need to click on your name. Then the ticket will be added to your name, guys. So let's see. Oh, this is like urgency, high, medium, low, and assigned to. So here you need to click on this search bar, and once you click on this search bar, you will be getting all these name, guys. So now I want to assign this ticket to Beth, guys. Beth Anglin. So once I click on this Beth Anglin, then the ticket will be getting assigned to Beth Anglin, guys. So this is how we will be assigning the ticket. And then next, there is a short description and description. So short description means whenever the user makes a call to you and he says that I'm facing issue with my keyboard or I'm facing issue with my so and so application, then you will be mentioning the exact issue, guys. In short description, you will be mentioning the exact issue, and under description, you will be mentioning the customer issue and even the troubleshooting steps performed by you. So what made the exact resolution? So what troubleshooting step has given the resolution? You need to mention each and every troubleshooting step performed by you in the description, guys. And at the bottom, you can see notes, related records and resolution information. So under notes, you can add the work notes, guys. You can add the work notes. So at the activities 3, you can see it here, right? I forgot to add something. So here you can write what you have if you want to add something. Here the customer has added system administrator. He added I need a keyboard. So in the same way, you can add something over here in the notes, guys. You can add something over in the, here in the notes. And then next, when it comes to the related records, we have an option called as parent incident problem. So under parent incident, if the customer is calling for an issue, and if you find out that there is an existing issue on the ticket, or if not, if the customer says that I'm facing so and so issue and there is already a ticket on this, then you can enter the ticket number over here, guys, parent incident. And when it comes to the resolution information, you have resolution code, you have resolution notes, guys. When it comes to the resolution code, you have all these options, guys. Solved permanently, solved remotely workaround, solved remotely permanently, not solved, not reproducible, not solved too costly, closed or resolved. So based upon the resolution you given, you need to select these options, guys. And when it comes to the workaround and permanently, so workaround in the sense, if the user is unable to open the URL in Internet Explorer, we are suggesting the user to go ahead and check with the Chrome and if it's working fine. So this is called as workaround. Permanently in the sense, if the customer says that I'm unable to open this URL in the Internet Explorer and you are performing the troubleshooting steps in the Internet Explorer, and if the issue has been fixed, then you need to select solved permanently, guys. When it comes to the resolved by, you need to mention your name. If you are resolving the ticket, then you need to mention your name. And when it comes to the date, you need to click here and you need to select the date, guys. So when the ticket has been resolved. And once the ticket has been created, you can see here, guys. See here, the incident number, open date, short description. So short description in the sense, the issue facing by the user. Well, look at here, email server is down. So the issue will be the short description, guys. And under caller name, you can see the David Miller. And the priority, critical, state, new, category, software or hardware. And look at these, guys. From the ServiceNow ticketing tool, not only from the ServiceNow ticketing tool, from any ticketing tool, the management can know total number of incidents created and what all the tickets are under open and what all the tickets are under resolved and what all the tickets are not open, not updated for so and so dates. So here, when we look at the incident overview, you can know that critical open incidents are 17 and open incidents are 40 and unassigned incidents are 15. Unassigned in the sense the tickets have been not assigned to any particular group or any particular person. And here the incidents not updated for 7 days or 36 days. So this is how the management manages the services, guys.